you'll never know that you are in an up unless that you go down.
When I opened the store, the whole roof collapsed and it's so much easier to quit.
That is exactly why I have this show. Fears don't exist. They're just in your mind.
Boca Athletica is an athleisure, gym, and fitness apparel boutique. The owner, Mauren Pardo, opened this bricks and mortar store following her dreams of becoming an entrepreneur. Conveniently located in the heart of Boca Raton, Florida, Boca Athletica's main objective is to provide their clients with fitness apparel that is not only comfortable, but also elegant. Now, here's the host of the Entrepreneurial Vibration Show, Sandy Viteri.
And here we are with Mauren Pardo from Boca Athletica. And as you can see, we're in a store, a retail store. And the reason why we're wearing something very casual today is intentional. Is because Mauren is the owner, is an entrepreneur, and is the owner of this beautiful store. And we wanted to talk to you, Mauren, today because obviously as an entrepreneur, you went through a process to open the store. But I wanted to take you back and actually figure out what was that process? What was that journey? So why don't you tell us and share with our audience, what was the journey that you went through to make that decision to become an entrepreneur?
Got it. So I actually went to FAU and I started entrepreneurship. So I always figured that I wanted to be a business owner eventually. So I pretty much have all the background on like how to do marketing plans, business plans, how a business should be run, what is needed. So once I graduated college, I got a full-time job working for a startup company just because I felt like I would get all the insights and I would learn from the person who I was hired by and my boss. And I did. I worked for a sunglass company for 5 years and I learned a lot. I did all the accounting. I also helped with like wholesaling. I did events on the weekends to kind of create branding. So I was very involved in like the whole process and the growth of the company. And after 5 years, I decided it was time for me to start my own thing. And since I'm a fitness fanatic, just like Sandy is, and I was very familiar with like clothing and I always have a hard time finding clothes because I'm very petite, I figured that it would be a good place to start my business owner journey. And that was it. And I was familiar with a lot of vendors. I always like quality. Mm-hmm. And I tried different brands and different things. So I was very knowledgeable on what I liked, what I didn't like. Right. And once I opened the store, that was one of the first brands that I started carrying that I personally worn throughout like my fitness journey.
So your main decision was based on a passion that you had. It was the fitness and you knew that you wanted to follow that. You wanted to open a store because you were passionate about fitness.
I always wanted to be a business owner just because I come from like entrepreneurship family per se. So mm-hmm. I felt like that was the closest thing I was familiar with, which was like fitness and retail, because I come from my parents used to have a like clothing store in like Colombia, so mm-hmm. I was very familiar on how things worked, and you know, and me being a girl and in the fitness world, I was very familiar with that subject. I always like retail, I always like fashion, I like clothing. I just because I'm not the same size as majority of the people are, I always have a hard time finding things that fit. Even though I know a lot of people shop online, but since my body is a little different, I actually like to try the stuff on. And I also find like a lot of older people were having a hard time finding things that fit and make them look good and feel confident. And I feel like there was a void in the market and a little bit of like looking a little bit edgy and the colors and the fit. So this is pretty much what I do here at Boca Athletica. I have clothing from Brazil and Colombia, so I offer quality 100%, and everything just looks good for like the curvy women.
Mm-hmm. I really like the fact that you said that you found a void in the market, you know, so can you expand a little bit on that? So specifically, what was that void, and then how Boca Athletica actually fulfills that void?
Okay. I feel like right now the market, people are buying a lot of like mainstream brands, and there's a lot of small companies that are mostly owned by women, like some of the brands I carry here. And these women put a lot of love in what they do and a lot of thought into the garments that they produce. And I feel like they were not being seen by the public as much as they should be. And just because of the quality and the price points are very comparable to other brands. So I felt like opening up a brick and mortar store was going to give the chance to people, like locals, to come and try this stuff on. People are like looking good and looking a little bit more fashionable. And I sell at the leisure, so you pretty much could wear this stuff all day. So any of my leggings, you could wear that dancing or to dinner and still feel confident. And just because I wear this stuff every day, even out to dinner, I felt like it was nice to have a good quality items that will make you feel like you wear them all day and you don't look like you're not dressed up enough. It's a little bit of me, obviously. A lot of me.
A lot Everything of you. Of I would say a lot of you. So how did you go about, obviously you didn't have a store before, you didn't necessarily have the whole experience, you had gone to school and learned a little bit about entrepreneurship. So how did you go about learning about your target audience and what their needs were?
As far as learning what the customers like, so I first started doing, before I opened the brick and mortar, I literally went to like shows. Let's say they were having like a little shopping event. I went to LA. I started trying to get in like some inventory. I went literally, like I still do this now, I will pull up a rack and sell clothing like literally like on the street or at the park where they're having some sort of event, like a food event or something. And I will kind of ask people like, what are you looking for? Do you want the sports bra that is like fashionable? Do you like support? Do you like the leggings that? So then I started getting feedback and asking my customers what they like. That way I was able to kind of buy the right things for the area. And once I felt like I had a little hold of what people respect, and like women would tell me that they want like supportive sports bras, like high support, because they are really out running. They're not, you know, they're trying to look cute at the gym. So I'm like, okay, we need high support sports bras. And or they would ask me for like just like nice shirts that still look very attractive, but just like a little more reflection of who they were. Mm-hmm. And people are always looking for good quality that you could like wash them all the time and they don't stretch out or the colors don't fade off.
Right. And that is so instrumental. So you touched on two very important points. One, obviously, really understanding your audience before you actually open your business, right? So you did something that I would call a hack, that, you know, understanding and going and doing the research and asking questions to your audience before you get started. You did an excellent job at doing that and getting all that feedback mechanism. So you had that information. Information is power. Okay, so having that information before you get started, you gather all that, and that gave you everything that you needed in order to get all the clothing that you know was going to, you were going to be able then to sell to the proper audience. We are here in an area in Boca Raton where you need to very specifically know which are the demographics that you're selling to. You know, it's specifically a female, what are their age groups, etc. And you said, you know, 80% or 70%, you said, you know, are within the ages of, you know, between 40 and above. So they like specifically something that maybe a 20-year-old is not going to like. Correct. So if you buy something for a 20-year-old, then they're not going to buy it and your store is not going to be successful.
Correct.
So that was point number one. And then point number two is continuous feedback, asking for that continuous loop of feedback.
I found out that going to gyms and doing marketing is really rewarding, just because people don't know that I'm here. And people often just buy on the spot because they like the stuff and they just don't have time to go to like to the mall or to come here or even to buy online. So you pretty much just bring the product to them at the inconvenience. And the fact that they know if they don't like it or if they have an issue, they could bring it back to a store and I'm open every day. And also like social media, like being on Instagram and just showing, I use all my own models. I don't use any stock photos from one of my vendors. I actually use only my customers that are currently buying from me, and you're next. When I make your model for me. Just because I feel like these are real people that are wearing my product.
And this is amazing. She's obviously full of hacks here for you guys. And I'm loving it. I'm all keeping it. Yeah, keep writing it down. But obviously the one of asking, where do you hear from me? You know, how do you learn about my business? You know, as you said, you know, when you are starting, you don't have a lot of resources, you don't have a lot of money, and knowing where people are hearing about your business will help you invest more of your time and effort into that. That is where you are going to see the return of your investment. So definitely a really great hack right there.
Now, we would love to hear from you. Tell us on the comments below, was this advice helpful to you today? And how can you put some of what you learn into practice right away to start to see a difference in your entrepreneurial journey? Also, don't forget, if you found this podcast helpful, make sure to subscribe, share with your friends, and hit the like button so we know to make more podcasts like this one.